This project started 4 years ago when the American Embassy of Trinidad requested that we could help restore the populations of white-faced tree ducks in Bahama pintails. They asked if we would work with Pointe-a-Pierre Wildfowl Trust in a plan to restore these species. The Pointe-a-Pierre Wildfowl Trust, headed by Molly Gaskin and Carolyn Shepherd, was founded in 1966. They are completely dedicated to the conservation of Trinidad's wild waterfowl. Through breeding and release programs, they have helped boost the populations of several of Trinidad's native species. I have known Molly Gaskin for well over 30 years, and this was a wonderful opportunity to support the goals and missions of both Sylvan Heights and Pointe-a-Pierre Wildfowl Trust.
So we began the complex process of exporting 12 white-faced whistling ducks and 12 Bahama pintail from North Carolina to Trinidad. All of these birds to be exported were hatched and hand-reared at the Sylvan Heights Avian Breeding Center earlier this year. Although there is always worries when transporting birds, we do everything possible to ensure the safety and comfort of the birds during travel. They were placed in sturdy crates, covered in mosquito netting, and given food and water to last the duration of the trip. I would accompany the birds to the trust to oversee their arrival and to advise Molly and Carolyn on the best practices for breeding and rearing these species. Molly and Carolyn from the Pointe-a-Pierre Wildfowl Trust retrieved the birds from the airport's customs, and the birds were finally on their last leg of the journey. Using the last light of the evening, we released the birds into their temporary quarantine aviaries at the Trust. We were so relieved to see the birds come out of their shipping crates looking healthy and energetic. The next morning, I got up at first light to check the ducks. Every one of them looked strong and healthy, and were beginning to settle into their new home. After all our hard work, it was so satisfying to finally see these birds here in Trinidad. I spent the rest of the morning exploring the Wildfowl Trust and found that it is not only a haven for wild waterfowl, but for many Trinidad's other native songbirds, waterbirds, and parrots. Later that day, I discussed aspects of breeding these birds with Molly and Carolyn, such as ideal nest boxes and which of their aviaries would best suit each species. We will continue to advise the staff at the Trust and provide any support necessary to ensure they are able to breed, rear, and eventually release the offspring of these 24 birds into Trinidad's wetlands.
Well, we are absolutely thrilled to have these birds here. It's a dream come true because we've been trying to get them for the past 10 years. These birds are part of Trinidad's bird life, part of the wetland waterfowl that we have in our country. But the population became less and less through so many different problems. And now we have, well, they're practically on the extinct list. So having these birds is fantastic. We would be breeding them, hopefully, successfully, and they're young. We are putting them back into the Carony and into the Oropouche wetlands. So Trinidad will have these birds once more, hopefully again, as plentiful as they once did. So thank you very much for all that you have done. We're very grateful.
Projects like this are why we do what we do here at Sylvan Heights. And our birds can contribute to the health of the wild population. Our mission is complete. In addition, the Wildfowl Trust will use our birds to educate the people of Trinidad in the conservation of wetlands and waterfowl, much like we do here in North Carolina at Sylvan Heights Bird Park.